Hi everyone. In this video, let us discuss about methylphenidate. What is this drug methylphenidate? This drug, also known as MPH, is one of the CNS stimulant, just like other drugs such as amphetamine. And being a CNS stimulant, this drug is indicated for the treatment of ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Similarly, this drug can also be indicated for treatment of narcolepsy, where a sudden bouts of sleep can be observed in the patients during the daytime. In such conditions, methylphenidate can increase the arousal and wakefulness. That's why it can reduce the narcolepsy within the patients. But nowadays, one of the main indications of methylphenidate is in the treatment of ADHD. So what is this ADHD? This is one of the hyperactivity disorder which is observed mainly in the children as well as in the adults. In such patients, we can observe some hyperactivity symptoms such as excitability and lack of focus, lack of concentration, resulting in some loss of memory, increased irritability as well as agitation, and the patients may have some indecisiveness. And commonly observed symptom is the disorganization, where they cannot sit in a proper way, they cannot manage the things in a proper way with some hyperactivity. So all these symptoms are collectively known as ADHD, which can be treated by methylphenidate. Even methylphenidate is a CNS stimulant, but still it can counteract this hyperactivity, because ADHD is mainly associated with mutations in genes coding for norepinephrine as well as dopamine transporters. Now, methylphenidate can act on these transporters so that it can reduce the symptoms in ADHD. So today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what is its chemical nature, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, it is the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of methylphenidate, and here we can simply observe the ester functionality. So let us give the numbering. This is 1 and this is 2. So simply it is a acetate derivative which is forming an ester with methyl group. So simply it is a methyl acetate. Now at the second position, it is attached with the phenyl ring. We can write this as 2-phenyl. Similarly, at the second position, piperidine ring is attached by second position. So 2-piperidine-2-aryl, that is the complete name of methylphenidate. So simply methylphenidate is the methyl phenyl acetate which is having the piperidine ring system at the second position. Now let us see how this drug acts. Even the exact mechanism of MPH is unknown, but it mainly acts by increasing the transmission of norepinephrine as well as dopamine. Within the CNS, norepinephrine acts as one of the important neurotransmitters. So these are the presynaptic neurons. On the postsynaptic neurons, adrenergic receptors such as alpha or beta receptors are located. Now when action potential reaches to the presynaptic neurons, calcium can enter to produce calcium-mediated exocytosis, which release the norepinephrine so that norepinephrine can act on alpha or beta receptors. So this produces postsynaptic excitation. But the action of release norepinephrine is controlled by its reuptake by norepinephrine transporter. Now the norepinephrine can be taken back again into the nerve terminal by this norepinephrine transporter. In this way, the effectiveness of norepinephrine is controlled by norepinephrine transporter. Similarly, another neurotransmitter within the CNS is the dopamine. So these are the presynaptic dopaminergic neurons, and these are the postsynaptic neurons on which dopamine receptors such as D2 receptors are located. Now again, by exocytosis, dopamine can be released and it can act on postsynaptic receptors, resulting in postsynaptic potential. Just like the norepinephrine, dopamine can be taken back again into the nerve terminal by dopamine transporters. Now the released dopamine can be taken into the nerve terminal through this transporter, which controls the dopaminergic transmission within the CNS. Now methylphenidate is a CNS stimulant which can act on this norepinephrine transporter as well as dopamine transporter, thereby inhibits the activity of these two transporters. And when these uptake transporters are inhibited, it results in the increased levels of norepinephrine as well as dopamine, within the synaptic cleft. In this way, methylphenidate increases the neurotransmission of norepinephrine as well as dopamine. What are the precautions of methylphenidate? One of the important precautions of methylphenidate is that this drug can activate not only the CNS, it can also stimulate cardiovascular system. Due to its stimulant effect on cardiovascular system, methylphenidate can increase the rate of contraction, so it can increase the risk of stroke in the patients as well as myocardial infarction. So whenever this drug is used, any symptoms such as severe chest pain, uncontrolled syncope, or any cardiac arrhythmias are observed, then immediately caution should be taken, as this drug may increase the risk of stroke and myocardial infarction within the patients. Similarly, the patients who are having any cardiomyopathy or coronary artery disease or any cardiac abnormalities such as structural as well as functional abnormalities, in such patients methylphenidate is contraindicated because it can further increase the complications resulting in sudden death within the patients. So in those patients with any cardiac abnormalities, methylphenidate is contraindicated. Similarly, this drug can affect the blood vessels so that it can increase the blood pressure within the patients. And similarly, it can also act on the heart, resulting in the increased rate of contraction, leading to tachycardia as well as palpitations within the patients. Similarly, this drug can act on the CNS, where it increases the norepinephrine as well as dopaminergic transmission. So because of elevated levels of dopamine within the CNS, it can produce some psychotic symptoms. So because of this CNS stimulation, methylphenidate can produce some hallucinations, delusions, even a phase of mania can be developed with this methylphenidate. So if any patient is already having any psychotic symptoms, then this drug should be carefully used. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of priapism, where prolonged erection of penis can be observed in the men. And it can also increase the peripheral vasculopathy, resulting in vasoconstriction and symptoms of Raynaud's disease. And within the children, it may suppress the growth by long-term administration. What are the side effects? The important side effects of methylphenidate are mainly related with cardiovascular system. So it can produce some palpitations, tachycardia, and it can also stimulate the CNS, resulting in anxiety, headache, insomnia, gastrointestinal side effects such as abdominal pain, dry mouth, nausea, loss of appetite, resulting in some weight loss can be observed with this methylphenidate. And it can also increase the disorientation of the patients along with excessive sweating. How it is given? This drug is available in different dosage forms such as tablet, SR tablet, sustained release tablet, which releases the drug very slowly. It is also available as chewable SR tablets, even capsules, SR capsules, solution, patches. In this way, in different dosage forms, methylphenidate is available. And the dose of the drug is individualized based on the patient conditions. So the dose may be variable from 20 to 30 mg given as either twice or thrice daily. The maximum dose of the drug is 60 mg per day, again given as divided doses. But in the children, the dose is somewhat less. It is started at 5 mg given twice daily. So that's about this drug, methylphenidate, which is a CNS stimulant, which is indicated for the treatment of ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, as well as this drug is also indicated for the treatment of narcolepsy. This drug inhibits norepinephrine as well as dopamine transporters. This may improve the symptoms within the ADHD, as well as it can also produce few of the symptoms such as increased stimulation of cardiac system, resulting in tachycardia, palpitations, and risk of stroke and death in the patients. It can also stimulate the CNS, resulting in hallucinations, delusions, and some manic phase. All these symptoms should be closely monitored when this drug is prescribed for long-term period. So that's about this drug, methylphenidate. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.